after.
The scene opens to a DJ at a nightclub. The club is just filled with people dancing. There's laser lights going off in every direction, and there's a high tempo song playing. Amongst the people in the crowd, there is Saki, who stops and walks away from the crowd that she's in to check her phone. She let out a frightened squeal, grabbing everyone's attention. Kokomi! No! Wasn't that just Saki, Phantomy Spade? A mysterious figure in the crowd watches Saki left out the door. Follow her and don't lose sight of her. The scene changes to just a black screen and a voice. Pinky. Pinky, come on, wake up. Wake up! Kokomi opened her eyes only to see a weird creature staring back at her. What are you? And why am I chained up? You're chained up because you made a foolish decision and thought it was going to work for you. I heard that you were, for lack of a better word, stupid, but I didn't expect this. This is the HQ for the Phantomy Faces. I'm sure you've heard about me from Gerano. The name is Heaven Starbright. The little creature teleported right next to him. And this is the god of chaos, Akumachi. You've made it to Phantomirage Act 2, Episode 16, and once again, there's a lot to unpack, so if you haven't seen the most recent video, the ticker is right there, and let's hop right into it. Saki was hurriedly walking towards her car. She stopped as soon as she grabbed the handle to her door. She noticed somebody was following her. Who's there? She screamed out as she turned around. Guess I'm busted. No need for alarm. I was only told to follow you. Whether or not I actually attack depends on you. Why would I attack a normal citizen? What are you talking about? That's where you're wrong. You see, there ain't nothing normal about me. The guy quickly swung his hand through the air and all four of Saki's tires on her car went flat. Just making sure you don't run away. Stormy has to have a word with you.
I don't have time for this right now. My friend is in trouble.
You don't get it. I'm not asking. I'm demanding. You're coming with me. Now. The scene changes to Yuri and Fandy in their headquarters. There, it's finished. Now she'll be able to teleport to each other as long as they're wearing their pendant.
Seriously, why have you never thought to make something like this before now?
I don't know. I do things on a whim. We should know this by now.
And that's why your plans are usually hit or miss. Anyway, I don't think they let Kokomi keep her pendant. That just would be sloppy of them.
But why would they kidnap Kokomi? What could they be after?
9 times out of 10, it was an unplanned kidnapping. She probably did something silly like threw herself in harm's way and they just took her with them. Now, what's interesting to note is that Joe Girl said that there was a third person with them.
The scene changes to Akia, who's next to Mariko, who just received a message from Fandy.
Right, so all I have to do for this to work is tap my pendant to the wrist and choose to go to Kokomi.
And do you honestly think that a wise decision?
There's only 2 possible outcomes. 1, they left her with the pendant so that you could teleport to her and they could spring a trap. Or 2, they took it away and nothing will happen.
Then what am I supposed to do? Sit here and wait? Your super seems to be the most level-headed of you three. Teleport to her and take me with you.
Okay, guess it's worth a shot.
Marco held on to Akia's shoulders as she teleported to Yotsuba and Fuka's apartment.
When they arrived, all they saw was Yotsuba sitting at the table looking lost in thought with a plate full of chicken nuggets in front of her.
Oh wow, looks like Marco was right. Seems like you're really focused. What'd you come up with?
I can't decide between the two.
2 options? Oh, this is interesting.
I mean, I already tried the honey mustard, but this new zesty sauce, I don't know. Should I try this or just go back to the tried and true honey mustard? And you say she is the most level-headed when she's over here worried about chicken nuggets.
Well, I have a plan if you're willing to listen to it.
The scene changes back to Kokomi trapped in the Phantomy Faces lair.
The God of Chaos? Why do you have him?
He's merely one piece of the puzzle. That's why we need Kumichi as well. Where is he? He's normally always with you.
Oh, yeah, about that. He's napping.
And what do you mean by napping exactly?
I don't know how to explain it, but my friend Yuri...
Yuri? Did you just say Yuri? As in Yuri Suzuhara Yuri?
Oh, you know her.
Not sure she's a bigger idiot than I thought and let that slip, or if she's just trying to bait me.
I think she's just messing with you. I've been telling them for a while, and not once have I seen her around anyone that she called Yuri.
Ah, not again.
Chiyo fell to her knees, holding her stomach.
I'll be back. I have to go see my sister.
With that, a group of golden butterflies flooded the room, and she teleported away.
Never mind her right now. This Yuri that you know. She has magical powers of some sort, yes? And she seems to be able to see into the future.
I don't know anything about seeing into the future, but her plans are pretty good. Maybe that's why.
It's a waste of time questioning her. She's oblivious, and even if she wasn't, she's not too bright.
Even so, if what she's saying is true, and the suits have both Kumichi and Yuri on their side, well, this might be even easier than I thought.
We'll soon be able to construct the ultimate weapon and wipe out the entirety of the reverse world.
Back with Saki, the guy looked ready to attack and she was cornered with nowhere to go.
Why does nobody ever take the easy option? They always want to cause a fuss.
Scorch, what's the holdup?
The guy turned around and saw the girl from earlier.
She should be no trouble for you to handle by yourself.
Saki took advantage of the small moment and put her pendant to her wrist and teleported to Yotsuba.
Seems like there were still kinks in the machine because she landed on her back on top of the table, smashing right into Yotsuba's chicken nuggets.
Hey, come on! My nuggets were right there!
Saki, are you okay? What happened?
Saki rolled off the table holding her back.
Ouch! Ouch! There was two people chasing me. I don't know what they want.
It's almost like that day when Advin attacked the city. There's so much going on all at once.
Could this all be planned like then?
I've been meaning to ask you, Mariko, why do you have magic and why do you help us?
I guess there's no point in hiding it anymore.
Mariko pulled out a compact and held it into the sky, and with the flash, her true form was revealed.
I am one of two guardian witches of this realm.
I know all about Kumichi and his true nature, and that is why I chose to side with you.
That's right. Mamie did say you were a witch. This is mind-blowing and all, but what are we going to do to get Kokomi back?
The scene changed to Tiffany, who is now back in Japan, and she's holding her purse, smiling. She said she heard a voice in her head. I don't know if this is one of the side effects of the amnesia or not, though.
I'm no expert, but I don't think voices in your head have anything to do with amnesia. We probably ought to take her to get re-examined again soon.
What was that voice, and what was that all about?
Your friends are here for you,
Clarissa stated as she walked into the room.
Tiffany, I'm so glad you're safe.
He had us really worried there, even after promising not to do anything reckless in America.
Hey, I remember you two.
You do?
Yeah, you're Riku and Rima. We're part of a famous J-pop group, and weren't there more of us?
No, that's not right at all. We're Anzu and Ayane.
Oh, wow, it's a nice purse. Where'd you get that from?
My doctor gave it to me as a birthday present, but there's this thing in it. What do you think it is?
Tiffany reached into her purse, and what she pulled out was something that was not expected at all. It was a Phantomy wrist.
Oh, that's nothing important, Ayane said as she snatched it out of her hand.
Give me that, Anzu said as she snatched it out of her hand. There's no point in lying to her.
Anzu handed the wrist back to Tiffany.
It's a Phantom Dao. You used to be obsessed with this hero group called the Phantomirage, and they would use these to transform. But why did your doctor have this? And why should she give it to you? It looks so real. It doesn't just look real. It is real. I can feel power coming from it. The same kind of power I could feel from the Kirameki powers. What do you mean you can feel power coming from it? Oh, it's just like I said, I can sense energy. Before your uncle adopted me, I used to be this super, super secret hidden boss. Okay, Clarissa, look, I don't know what game you're playing, but this isn't funny. She doesn't have her memory back and you're going to confuse her. No, I think she might be telling the truth. I don't know why, I just feel it. Like, why else would my doctor give me this thing? And does that mean that my dream, the one that I can't remember, was to be a superhero? That's enough. My daughter doesn't need you to bombard her with silly ideas about being a hero. Leave. Sorry, we didn't mean any offense, Mr. Wheeler. I said leave. She needs to rest. Anzu and Ayane just nodded their heads and left out the room. The scene changes to a random place across town, and Chia was sitting on a hospital bed with her ribs bandaged up. What am I going to do with you? You keep using that thing even after it keeps damaging your body. Look, if a couple of bumps and scratches are the price to pay for peace, so be it. I have a duty to protect this realm. Says who? Who is making you do this? This was your choice. You didn't have to do it. You could have just gave him back that little weird thing and said, you don't want it. I mean, if you want to be a hero, that's good. That's great. But there's other ways to do it. Can't you just do it like Linda's husband at least? Did you really just compare me to that bald idiot? Did I just hear you talking trash about my lovely husband and his sexy bald head? Linda, great. Didn't know you were home. I thought you had a modeling event or something to do. You can't really think Lieutenant Baruti is handsome, right? I mean, look at him. He has a certain sophisticated, mature charm that I wouldn't expect you two to understand. You're much too young. But anyway, I agree with Hinoka. You shouldn't keep using that thing if it's going to keep damaging you every time you use it. Well, it's not every time. It's just when I overdo it, which I guess kind of happens a lot. Yeah, you're just like Mom. You don't know how to be subtle about anything. You just overdo it all the time. Chio, you need to really lay off of that because we don't really have batteries to charge that thing in our realm. And once it runs out, I can't heal you up again. You're going to end up hurting yourself permanently. Kurumi says it uses chaos energy. Why would you even use something that has chaos energy? That doesn't even sound safe. Would you two just get off my back about this? I didn't come here for a lecture. I just came to get patched up so I can get back to work and protect Earth. The scene changes back to Fandy and Yuri. There's been a breach. It seems like it happened 2 days ago. 4 people came through. These aren't just any 4. These are the elites. This is Zetsubou and his cronies. The forces of darkness seem like novices compared to them. That's not really saying much. I'm pretty sure the girls can just get some kind of a buff and take him out. No problem. That's not how it works this time. There's absolutely nothing we can do unless all 8 Phantomi come together to stop him. Like I said, no problem. Just give it a few episodes and everything will be okay. They're foreshadowing as thick as oatmeal right now. The scene changes back to Kokomi. That's insane. I can't just sit back and let you do that. You want to use Kumachi's power to destroy your whole realm? Why would you want to do something that crazy? Isn't that your home? Isn't that where you're from? I pledge absolutely no loyalty to any land. The only thing I pledge loyalty to is justice. I'm not afraid to get my hands dirty for the greater good. Unlike Geronimo, I'll do whatever it takes to put an end to this. They'll just keep coming back if we don't stop them. How many years has it been? 3? 4? You thought everything was fine. You thought you were safe. And then the 4 Seasons of Darkness came back and you knew nothing about them until Geronimo told you. I grew up there. I lived there. I can tell you from experience, there is no good left in those people's heart. There is no swaying them. The only way to win is to wipe them from existence like they were planning to do you.
Right at that moment, the other Phantomi as well as Marco and Fuka teleported into the base. Wow, they actually did not take her pendant away. Cool. That means Fuka's plan is sure to work now. Are you actually foolish enough to think that you can beat us on our own turf? It's 1 versus 5. I don't think you understand the odds here. Just then, Jorno fired a golden beam from his hand, hitting all 5 of them, knocking them to the ground. 2 versus 5. I'm not a pacifist like Jorno. That attack seems similar to what Joker does. How? How is he able to do that without transforming at all? I'm not sure, but I think that just completely destroyed my plan. What are we gonna do now? Well, it looks like our girls got themselves in a fine mess this time. They storm the base, expecting a 1-on-5, but have a 2-on-5. Heaven possesses a mysterious power that no one really understands. 4 others from the reverse world have breached into the Earth's realm. Chiyo's body is taking recall from using the Phantomi dial. And the 4th and final Phantomi wrist, the star model, is in possession of Tiffany and her friends. What could this all mean? Find out next time on Phantomirage Act 2.